do to make county government more user-friendly for residents and businesses that rely on the services it provides? Please provide an example.
First of all, I think the most important thing, again, is economic growth. Economic development is our MO. We have to make sure that we have businesses, we have people to employ people so they can live, spend money, put money into the economy, put money into other businesses, and so there is growth. My example would be hiring an economic development director, having somebody focused on that. As far as dealing within the community, you know, every single dollar that is spent within the commissioner's budget makes me think about economic development and how they can basically bring economic growth into Stark County. I'm not saying that that's the end all, but I'm saying that's the first step in addressing this issue. I have experience working in Columbus, and I would use my resources in Columbus to bring in certain entities like matching dollars for certain programs that is offered by the county commissioners. I want to make sure that that is held to the top priority and that economic growth is put on the forefront.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Smith?
Could you repeat, please?
I just want to make sure I'm on track.
All right, we're fine. What would you do to make county government more user-friendly for residents and businesses that rely on the service that it provides? And please provide an example.
Okay. One of the biggest examples that I came across, and I probably helped initiate that as a township trustee with the county commissioners, and that was get our building department squared away so it wasn't 3 to 4 weeks to even do a plan review for the simplest of things. We had a situation with Pilot Flying J coming in, and it was ridiculous. 44 revisions off of something that is state regulated across the state building codes, and they had 44 revisions on the forensic line. And then they had to come back again, and because they questioned them why they couldn't get their permit, it was 12 more revisions, for example. They had to show an architectural drawing on how they were going to hang a fire extinguisher on the wall before they could get the permit to build. This is one of the things all blew up, and I started working with the commissioners, and we were able to get Angela over there, Angela Kavanaugh. She had done a great job. The other thing that I had suggested, and I think that the commissioners were already on track with that, was you have to be friendly. When you go into the building department and you don't, they don't know if you're the biggest developer or not, but you could go in there and somebody should be jumping over that counter and giving you a big bear hug saying, thank you for coming in to Stark County and wanting to invest, okay? And so they also moved the building department up where it was more convenient. It wasn't downtown, and you can get to them. Angela's done a good job. That's one of the greatest examples that has happened, and working together with them. But I also think you could do one more step, and that would be is I would take, and I'm not saying there's going to be one health department or one building department in the county, but I think you take and you do collaborate. You get some of the cities and the villages, the towns together, and you start working at where can you collaborate together and have these services under one shelter, you know, one health department, one building department. If it's possible, you know, then do that. And if it's not, but the taxpayer has to come out on top, and that has to be looked at. And I think we have some people in place in the right cities now that would at least look at that. And then it would be an economic benefit for all.
Thank you,